you know, as busy as your 2019 has been, and as eventful and you know, and fantastic as it's been, have you been able to like listen to any music, see any you know, any movies and stuff? Because you know, it's our mid-year review as well. You know, I mean, we're gonna do the Hands of Time at the end of the year, but in July right now, has anything stood out to you, music-wise, yeah, movies-wise?
Well, I guess we could go with movies first. I mean, movies, I really didn't miss anything because the only big film that came out in my Academy time was Avengers. And literally, yo, that day is crazy. So anyone who tried to get Avengers tickets knows it was a pain in the ass overall to get, you know, where you wanted to, the time you wanted. You had to make some sacrifices. Mm-hmm. Me personally, I love AMC and the reclining seats and all that shit. And even though you're talking about Regal, I bagged my seats on Regal, but the Regal by me is like regular seats and like that bum shit. So I literally, the Regal by me is Poughkeepsie, is about 45 minutes. Mm-hmm. And Danbury, Connecticut's only an hour. So 15 minutes more, I bagged AMC tickets for that. But the funny shit is that, so that was a Friday. So Friday mornings is what we consider hardcore PT. So we basically, that's when we get the shit beat out of us the most in the Academy. Mm-hmm. So literally we woke up at 4 in the morning, from 4:30 a.m. to 7 o'clock in the morning, nothing but push-ups, sit-ups, and getting fucked up. Then I had class the whole day, had to take a major exam at the end of the day. Then I had to drive home, get changed, and drive all the way to fucking Danbury to watch the movie at 11 o'clock at night. The shit didn't end till 2 in the morning, bro. Mm-hmm. But it was worth it. But that's the only movie that came out in that time frame that I had to kind of rush. Because even, like, I saw John Wick 3, but that came out on the 18th. Mm-hmm. So I had time to see that one because of the weekend time. Besides that, I mean, for the most part, I've seen all the big ones. I took my daughter to see Aladdin. I saw Avengers. I saw Captain Marvel. Mm-hmm. What else was there? I saw Shazam, which I thought was really good. Like, to me so far, that's my favorite DC film. Just because I thought it had that Guardians of the Galaxy vibe. Like, it was funny, but it was still a really good movie. And they did a good job with the comic book character. I can't speak as far as story because I don't follow DC mainly. So besides Batman Superman, I can't really speak. Mm-hmm. So I don't know how well it followed the comic book, but I enjoyed the shit out of the movie. I mean, the story wasn't as good as like Aquaman or Wonder Woman, but the way they held it together, like you enjoyed it, and it was, like I said, it was fucking hilarious. And the dude who played him was fucking great, so I definitely enjoyed that. But yeah, I really didn't miss much. Like, I saw Glass, I saw Us. Us probably my favorite movie of the year so far. But I saw Us. What else came out? I saw Rocket Man. I enjoyed that too. I'm a big Elton John fan, so I enjoyed that too. It just, that movie was different though, because I thought it was like, kind of like Bohemian Rhapsody, where it was a straight documentary biography kind of thing. Right. And it wasn't. This was more like a visual interpretation of the way he expresses his life through music. So it wasn't like a full-on documentary. It was, but it wasn't a full-on biography kind of thing. But I still enjoyed it. The kid who played him did a good job. And I found out that unlike Bohemian Rhapsody, where it was a mix, almost all Freddie Mercury's vocals with a mix of this dude's own, this shit was all him, no Elton John. Like, every time he was singing, it was him singing. Okay. I was impressed by that. But, you know, the kid from Kingsman.
Yeah.
That was pretty cool. What else came out?
I haven't seen that yet. I haven't seen Rocket Man. I do want to see it. Yeah,
I enjoyed that.
Musical.
I definitely enjoyed that. I want to see Yesterday. I haven't seen that yet. I'm a big Beatles fan, too. So, Yesterday?
Oh, okay. Yeah, I haven't seen that yet.
I'm a big Beatles fan, so I'm hoping that's good, too.
Yeah. Yeah, I want to see that one, too.
But, yeah, Captain Marvel, Endgame, John Wick, Aladdin. Like, there were some big ones this year. It's been a good year so far. It's a big year for Disney, man. You got Toy Story 4, which I fucking love. That shit. You seen Toy Story 4? Come on, bro. You missing out. You're an adult.
Kids now, man. I couldn't go up in the theater by myself, just sitting in the back. Like, nah, it wasn't happening, man.
Go for the late night show where no kids should be there.
I was gonna try that, but they didn't really have that many.
Take a shorty. They have a shorty who was gonna go see Toy Story.
Not that I want to go see it with.
You can fake for the funk for the Toy Story. Half her buy the tickets.
That's like, yo. I wanted to see it. What do you think about Endgame still being right behind Avatar as far as the money goes?
Fucking terrible, bro. I mean,
how many times did you go see it?
I've only seen it twice.
Okay.
So I only see it once. Yeah, I watched it when it first came out. I watched it that Friday, and then I rewatched it now with the re-release, and I got played like all the other fans.
Well, I've been trying, like I said, I only saw it once. I kept wanting to see it again, and time wasn't working, whatever. Then when they said, oh, they're adding the footage, I was like, all right, bet. But then I saw what the footage was, and I was just like, I still want to see it, but I'm like, nah, y'all got to do better than that. And to me, I feel like they could have done better. Like, they just basically finished finalizing the Blu-ray, and it was like, well, let's give them a couple clips from that. Like, the unedited Hulk scene, and it was like, come on, y'all could at least finished it.
I mean, except for Captain Marvel and both the Ant-Mans, Captain Marvel I saw twice. So I watch all Marvel movies. I go at least twice in the movie to see them. So watch it the first time, get my first reaction, and watch it the second time, get to enjoy it without the fans all making noise. And I watch it a little bit later. So I want to see Avengers again regardless. This gave me extra incentive.
Yeah.
Plus, I'm a nerd. I'm a fanboy. So I had to go and, I had to go for that thing. I had to go for that little poster they gave, bro.
Right.
Big,
I guess I wanted to see it again. It was just, like I said, because it's a three-hour movie, a lot of the times they kept having wasn't working in my schedule. So I just didn't get a chance to see it again. I saw John Wick twice. You know what I'm saying? That was like the only movie I think I saw twice this year. But other than that, when Endgame was coming, when they were talking about Endgame, I'm like, I'm going to see about 3, 4, 5 times. And so at once.
Fucking... Nah, I enjoyed John Wick. Endgame though, like that's another one, bro. Endgame, the only showing they had was 4 o'clock, and that was literally I was coming off of doing a double, so I worked 11 o'clock to 7 a.m. then 7 a.m. to 3 p.m. Mm-hmm. So I did a double, got out doing an overnight shift with no sleep, watched a 3-hour movie. I had to race down the middle of town to go watch it. Like, literally because I'm a nerd and I need that poster. But nah, I mean, like I said, I liked it. I liked Avengers Endgame overall. John Wick, though, I enjoyed a lot. I don't want to spoil anything, but John Wick came out back in May, so anyone who didn't watch it, that's your fault.
Oh yeah.
The only thing I didn't like was the ending, only because it kind like him getting shot a bunch of times, and cut up a bunch of times, and surviving already made it a little like all right, this. But him with falling off the roof and it made it completely unrealistic.
Yeah, that was the only part to me too that I was just like, oh come on. Like him getting shot. Okay, we know he got the suit. The suit is bulletproof, but he ricocheted off the fire escape, banged off the wall, hit the ground, and then he just had a limp.
Exactly, and the shit is like, I mean, he was all fucked up. He got brought to in a wheelbarrow and shit. He was all fucked up, but he stood up.
If he would have fell,
landed on a small little thing, and then rolled over and then fell onto an awning, and bashed into something, hit the foot, and the thing is, don't get me wrong, this dude has survived that before. But when you add that plus all the shots and stabbings he took throughout the last few movies, that kind of made it I know it's just a movie, but it's a movie about a real person, a human being. So it was but overall, I still love that. I'm still hyped for the fourth one.
Oh yeah, for sure.
What?
As I said, for sure. It's just a fun series definitely. To watch.
This one's doing a prequel too, a TV show prequel on the Continental, supposedly. So I'm hyped to watch that too. I'll definitely check that out.
Yeah.
Then what else? You got, like I said, I told about Shazam already. Toy Story 4, I loved. Glass, I enjoyed. Yeah. A lot of people gave it criticism. I like the way he did it. I thought he did a good job with Glass. Definitely thought it was a good ending to trilogy. Well, getting to the trilogy, prequel trilogy, depending on what he does with it.
Right. That'll be the end of it though. I think Shyamalan's gonna end it there. He kind of made his point and he left it for you to think about what could happen next. You know what I mean? So I think that was kind of his planning on it. So I definitely like that. A lot of people thought it was going to be like a Marvel movie, but it's going to be an epic battle scene at the end, but it was more of a thought-provoking, piece. And that's what I liked about it. You got to fight early, and the rest was more kind of a mystery kind of thing. Where is it going to go? Are they really superhuman? Or are they not? She's telling them they're not. She had you kind of doubting it. And then in the end, you find out, they are, and, there's more people like them, and, so I like the way, the way it was left off, so I definitely appreciate the Glass, for sure.
Nah, so far, my favorite movie of the year is Us. I've been looking at, what's coming out and everything. I don't see anything. The only movie that might even be a competitor for me for a movie of the year, besides Us, is Once Upon a Time in Hollywood, because, one, I'm a huge Leo fan, I'm a huge Brad Pitt fan, and I'm the world's biggest fucking Tarantino fan. I have a back piece I've been working out as my tattoo for a Tarantino fucking epilogue, fucking whole fucking collage. I love Tarantino. He's my favorite director of all time. I love all his movies. I think Tarantino does no wrong. Even his worst movie, in my opinion, Jackie Brown, is still better than a lot of trash out there. I love Tarantino. So I'm really hyped for that movie. I'm hoping, you know, because his script writing is, that's what it's all about. His script writing is just phenomenal. So I'm hoping that with a mix of Leo and Brad Pitt, I think they could do something special with that. But so far, Us is my movie of the year. Mm-hmm. I don't see anything that's going to change it. Like, I'm hyped for Lion King. I want to see it, but I already seen Lion King, the cartoon. So it's not like it's not too much going to change. I'm like, oh my God.
And you know what I mean? How you feel about Lion King?
What?
I said, we know how you feel about the Lion King.
I think Lion King's a good movie. I just don't think it's the best of all time. That's an insult to a lot of Disney work, in my opinion.
Listen, man.
It's a good movie.
You can see how much effort they're putting into, well, put into the movie. Like, all of the remakes they've done, like Aladdin, for example, the biggest name they had was Will Smith. You know, all Beauty and the Beast, the biggest name they had was, what's her name from Harry Potter? Like, they picked one star here and there, but for Lion King, they went all out. Like, they went all out. They got James Earl Jones back. Beyonce, Childish Gambino, like they got Key and Peele, like they went all out for the cast. Like,
well, I think, I mean, I could be wrong, but I think that's a movie that a lot of people also want to be a part of. Like, I wouldn't be surprised if a lot of people were like knocking on the door, like, hey, I want in on this, like, I want a part of this also.
Possibly, but it's a
big film. No.
And it's definitely a big film.
But yo, it's at the end of the day, yo, it's a huge fucking year for Disney, bro. Oh, Toy yeah. Story 4, Lion King, Avengers. And then you got fucking Star Wars ending the year off. And I think, if I'm not, you know, let me know. This is the last Star Wars, supposedly, right? This is number 9. It ends the whole thing, allegedly. Correct. Well, for the series that we know.
Yeah, unless they change
that's going to be huge. Again,
but Star Wars movie. Yeah. This is the end of this saga, whatever. And who knows what they're going to do with it next. They might do more spinoffs of individual characters. They're going to have shows and stuff on the Disney network, on the Disney streaming app. But yeah, this movie's supposed to be the one to end off this story. So yeah.
And then, I mean, you got, what else? You got a few other things coming out by the end of the year. I mean, you got, the only one that I think is going to be, in my opinion, is going to do financially decent, but I'm not hyped for it at all, is the Hobbs versus Shaw or Hobbs and Shaw shit. They made it too much. I mean, Fast and Furious is already going in a crazy direction. Mm-hmm. Although, in my opinion, and this one's that I'll probably make an unpopular opinion episode. I've seen a lot of people trash it. In my opinion, for what it is, it's a popcorn action movie. None of them are bad. Like, they're all entertaining. Because even the worst ones, I catch, like, I'll put on, I want to watch the whole thing and, like, entertain. Because they're still entertaining. They're terrible. They defy physics and the law of gravity and everything we've ever learned in school. Yes. But they're very, very entertaining overall. So, I mean, if Dwayne The Rock Johnson is able to push a submarine torpedo out the way, you know, so be it. I'm with it. Like, the you know, but this one just looks like, well, not only went over the edge, but it just doesn't, it's not, it would have been good as own standalone movie, like without no tag to Fast and Furious, just two different characters who, like, anyway, I'm not running to the theaters to see it. If I miss it in the theaters, I'm not gonna cry.
Yeah, I think they should have just did two totally different characters, The Rock and what's his name, I can't think of his name.
Jason Statham.
Statham, yeah, The Rock and Statham. Should have had them do this movie, but just different characters. Don't put it Fast and Furious. Just leave it on its own, because in the Fast and Furious world, it doesn't really make sense, because it's like, oh, they need help. They need backup. And instead of calling the people that they've been dealing with, they go to The Rock's house, and she don't have no weapons. So again, they still don't call Dom and them. They just... Like, it just doesn't really blend in. And then,
I'm sure there'll be something cheesy in the movie real quick to be like, oh, we couldn't call Dom because, and everything's like simple and solved. Like, oh, they're, you know, they're busy fighting a volcano or some shit. Who knows? But I'm sure that line will come up real quick.
Yeah.
Then personally, because my son Benjamin decided to come early and mess up some plans, but I'm happy for his arrival. I haven't seen Spider-Man yet, so I'm still waiting on that. Hopefully I'll get to see it sometime this week. I still haven't seen Spider-Man. I'm a horror fan, so I did want to see Annabelle. It actually got decent reviews compared to the other one, but the other two that I'm big on is It Part 2. I'm hyped for that. I want to see how that turns out. I'm a big Stephen King fan. I like It. I like the remake, and not as much as the first one. I like the remake. And then Scary Stories to Tell in the Dark. I was a big fan of the books as a kid, so the fact they were coming out with a movie, I can't wait to see that. I'm kind of hyped for that one. Besides that, though, like, there's not much the rest of the year. Like, I was looking at the releases and stuff coming out. There's nothing for me personally I'm, like, super hyped about. Mm-hmm. There'll probably be, like, one or two films that we didn't know were going to be a big deal, ones being pretty good.
Right.
I know there's one I haven't seen yet that I want to see called Captive State that came out not too long ago. It's supposed to be pretty good. And then another one called Brightburn. They're, like, original kind of movies with original ideas. I like that kind of shit, so I'm going to try to check those out. Besides that, movie-wise, that's all I got.
Brightburn was interesting.
It
was an interesting spin on, like, the Superman, you know, what if. So it was interesting. It wasn't great, but it was interesting. You know, it was one of those. So it was okay. Like, I don't even know what to say. Like, I mean, nothing really to spoil, but it was just like I said, it was one of the movies that I was like, okay, it's an interesting what if tale. You know, if what if Clark Kent kind of, cause they couldn't use like Clark Kent or Superman or any of the DC terminology in it. And it was like, what if, you know, Kal-El came and realized his powers, he got bullied and he just fought back and just, you know, fought back and just used his powers against people that bullied him as a kid and stuff like that. So it was interesting. But
I definitely want to see. I just didn't get a chance. So I just kept missing it because that's not when it came out during a weird time frame for me. So mm-hmm. I kept missing it. But yeah, I mean, like I said, so far, you know, but I don't see much changing except for maybe Tarantino. So at the end of the year, you know, when we do our recap, it looks like Us is gonna take it for me because this was not a big year. I love the Endgame. Mm-hmm. I like the way they finished it off and the way they did things, but it still left some parts of it made you feel like that rush of the fan, but there's some parts of it made you feel like you wanted more on certain parts of it. So it wasn't, you know, it wasn't the super, super climax. Like, I enjoyed Infinity War more than I enjoyed Endgame, honestly. Yeah. I did. So the ending of Endgame was dope. Like, the last, you know, when you know, Thanos finally comes and everything was dope. But there was parts that were funny and cool with them chasing down the Infinity Stones. But the overall, you know, the non-use of the Hulk, like, there's just so much that I have that I was just not a fan of that they could have done better on. Mm-hmm. But, you know, that's just my own little gripe. I'm still a fan. I'm just sad there's no more Marvel movies the rest of this year besides, you know, Spider-Man for me. But everything else came out already for Marvel. Mm-hmm. I'm probably going to check out Star Wars. I don't think I've ever seen a Star Wars in the theaters, ever. I think I might have saw Revenge of the Sith, episode 3, in the theaters, because my ex-girl at the time wanted to go see it, and I was like, all right, we'll go see this shit. And I actually wound up liking it, but yeah, I don't think I've ever seen a Star Wars in the theaters when I think about it. I'm pretty sure I've seen them all either bootleg back in the day, you know, bootleg DVD, or I happen to watch, like, catch them on TV or something like that.
Yeah.
And then I actually bought The Force Awakens, or Last Jedi. I bought one of them, and that one was pretty good.
Mm-hmm.
So I'll probably check this one out. I've seen them all, so I'm up to date. I haven't seen Solo. I haven't seen Rogue Squadron or Rogue One or whatever it's called. Rogue
One. Yeah.
I haven't seen that one, but I've seen all the live action movies. I've mm-hmm. seen all of them except for that one. So I'm gonna check it out. Hopefully it's good.
Yeah, no, it should be. I mean, the next Star Wars, I'm skeptical about it because they kind of dropped the ball on the last one on where the story's going. It was like J.J. Abrams did the first one, then the last joint was done by the other dude, and it was like he went a totally different direction, and then now J.J. Abrams is bringing it back. So it's like it needs to come off cohesive, and I don't know how they're gonna make that happen and where they're gonna even go with it, because the trailer they dropped had the senator doing his evil laugh at the end of it. So I'm like, all right, they're bringing him back. Like, you know, I'm just skeptical. I'm just waiting to see where they're going to go with it. I'm waiting to see another trailer and see, you know, what the plot of the story is going to be. So I'm waiting to see that. But that's all the way in November. But what you got as far as music, any albums came out that you got on rotation?
Just to touch on Star Wars, because you know more than I do. Is there a chance they bring Darth Maul back? Because I was a fan of that character, and I felt like him dying off didn't build. They could have built so much more with him.
There's a chance. He did come back in one of the animated, I think it was the Clone Wars cartoon. He came back with like spider legs, like mechanical legs and stuff. Because obviously he got cut in half. He got cut, so they put his torso on like a spider body thing, but I don't know if they're gonna bring him back because when Disney took it over, they kind of changed what was canon and what wasn't. So I don't know if they're going to keep him and bring him back into the movie. I don't know. I don't know. But like I said, this movie can go really any direction. So I don't know where they're going to go with it.
Really?
Nah.
So, I mean, oh, and when I forgot to mention also, Joker, I'm not sure how I feel about it still.
Right.
I have no clue how I feel about it. I'm going to see it. I'm definitely going to see it, you know, first. I'm going to try to see it first weekend it comes out. But I'm not sure how I feel about it because, to me, you know how I am, your bro. I'm not a fan of DC. I hate DC. I think Batman's a good character. But I think, much like Spider-Man, like, he's also made by his villain. Like, his villains help make him a better character. I think he probably – actually, way more than Spider-Man. His villains make him. Without his villains being so good and so deep, I don't think he's as interesting of a character. At the end of the day, he's just a regular dude with a lot of money. But his villain, in my opinion, his villains helped build him.
Mm-hmm.
So, you know, I'm actually hyped for this. So, like, one of my favorite, actually two of my favorite comics of all time are both just purely based on the Joker. So I'm hoping they don't ruin this, even though I know it's not a direct DC villain Joker with a Batman. This is more like a prequel origin story, but, like, it's going to have nothing to do with anything in the DC universe. So it's a standalone film, and I don't get what they're doing with it, but, you know, they have a huge director, huge actor. Joaquin Phoenix is one of my favorites. So, you know, he's a great mythic actor, so I can't wait to see what he does with the movie. But, you know, we'll see how that works out. Oh, shit. Actually, that other shit looks good, too. I think it's, what, 21 Bridges? The shit with
Black Panther? Chadwick Boseman. Yeah.
That might be good as well.
That
so
interesting, too, yeah.
Looking forward to that. And then as far as music goes, so far for year end, usually when we're this way halfway in, me and you have, like, a debate on what our number one is, what might not be number one. Honestly, I don't got shit for this year.
Because last year, we got spoiled because by this time last year, everything was out.
Yeah, but even the projects that came out so far have been disappointing.
Yeah.
So for me right now,
we've really only gotten stuff recently. You know, recently we got, you know, Revenge of the Dreamers just came out. You know, Khaled dropped something recently, you know, Chris Brown, like a lot of stuff came within like the last month or two. But, you know, last year we had albums from January, February that was, you know, made it to our top five at the end, you know, cause what last year was what, I think Book of Ryan came out like February, March, right?
Yeah. Something like that.
Came out early. Nick Grant's joint came out early. What else? Like a bunch of stuff came out early last year, whereas now they're finally rolling a lot of stuff out now.
I'm trying to think. Like, I can't think of anything that's coming out that I'm real hyped for, except for what? Jordan Lucas. I'm hoping that album drops this year. There's been a lot of build to it, so I'm hoping that album drops. But even then, quite a few singles from that song with that ADH picture has been released, where it's gonna be like, all right, well, I already heard these songs, so it doesn't feel like a new album. Mm-hmm. Especially if he was gonna do some kind of concept album or anything like that, it's kind of ruined now. Mm-hmm. Because he dropped so many songs without dropping an album. I mean, I know he handles his own masters. I know he does his own recording, his own studio time. He pays for everything himself, so I understand his method behind it. But in my opinion, if you go on iTunes right now, like Apple Music, he has like 10 singles out, all with the ADHD picture, which makes me feel like that's part of the album. Mm-hmm. So I feel like I technically already heard the album. Unless he's doing 20 songs, I feel like I already heard almost the entire album. Mm-hmm. And although I like it, it's not going to have the same impact when I finally get to listen to it as a whole, because mm-hmm. the way he released it, in my opinion. I'm waiting on him.
Did you listen to Revenge of the Dreamers?
I'm going to get to that in 1 second.
Okay.
West Side Gun got something coming out. I'm hopeful for. And then Nas, The Lost Tapes. I'm hoping that's something good in there. But that could be hit or miss. Now, yeah, to talk about the albums that come out so far, I'll go backwards. I'll start with the ones that are out right now and then go backwards. But
okay.
I was really disappointed in Revenge of the Dreamers, honestly. You know, I rock with J. Cole. I love J. Cole. I defend him all the time.
Mm-hmm.
I was really hyped for this album because he has such a hard fucking click behind him. Like, a lot of people, in my opinion, don't know a lot of the artists there. Like, the R&B chick, phenomenal. Fucking that kid Saba, I'm a big fan of. I talked about him before. Like, his album came out in the beginning of the year. It was a pretty good album. I never heard of. I love JID, so I was hyped for this album. And then even fucking Earth Gang, Bishop put me on the Earth Gang, mm-hmm. and I listened to that album, was dope. So I was like, all right, you know, I'm hyped for this. And then the album comes out, and there's like two or three songs that I'm really feeling. The rest of the easy skips. The fucking, I don't know who chose the beat and the hook for that Wells Fargo song, but it's the most annoying thing I ever heard in my life. Like, it's, you know, like I had to turn it off because it was just like the hook and the way they're yelling is just like, it's the most annoying shit ever.
Mm-hmm.
Obviously, you know, Cole did his shit on some of the verses. You know, he does what he does, but
he shines on every verse he's on.
Yeah, the album doesn't stand out.
Yeah,
Lorenzo the Dreamer's 2 is a way better fucking album, yes, in my opinion. A way better album. So I was really disappointed because I was hyped. Like, literally, I finally waited. I was like, oh, it's 2 a.m. Let me download this shit. I was in the hospital actually with the baby. You know, waiting for the baby to come home. I'm in the hospital. And I'm like, it's 2 a.m. I got nothing else going on. Let me try to download this album. So I downloaded the album. Fucking disappointed. I was like, oh, you know what? Maybe because I'm half asleep. Baby got me crying. Baby, you know, waking me up on the shit. So maybe I'm half asleep. Mm-hmm. The next day, I had to drive home to pick up the baby, to pick up my daughter. So I was like, on the drive there, it's like 35 minutes. I like, bumped the album. Still disappointed. Mm-hmm. Third time playing through, I was like, nah, this album's not getting better. Like, this is it. Mm-hmm. So I'm really disappointed.
Same. I downloaded it overnight. So Friday morning, I said, all right, I'm listening to it on the way to work. Went through it, and I was just like, okay. Until it again on the way home after work, I was just like, okay. I played it again Saturday, and I was just like, yeah, I'm not bugging. It's just nothing stands out. It's a compilation, and I know it's supposed to be featuring the Dreamville artists, but to me, a lot of the outside people stole the show. As far as Dreamville goes, you know, Cole and JID, they stood out, but everybody else really got outshined by the baby on the first track. He did his thing. T.I. on the joint with JID, he did his thing. Like, a lot of the other people stood out. I do like the R&B joint with Ty Dolla Sign and Ari Lennox. But yeah, it's about maybe 4 or 5 songs. Like I said, I can listen to every J. Cole verse, every JID verse. Everybody else is hit or miss.
It's disappointing. It's just a disappointing album, man.
Especially because we waited since January for it. Like, yeah. They did the documentary. They said it was recorded in 10 days. It was invitation only. Everybody came through, and you got so many producers and stuff. So they, from what I heard, there was about 100 and something songs recorded.
But they chose the wrong ones.
These are the songs they chose. These are the ones we got. And I'm like, then we need a J. Cole album. We need a JID. We need an Earth Gang. We need the album from these guys with those other songs.
Cause like, even now, I'm trying to think without looking at my phone. I'm trying to think of any songs. And besides Middle Child and the song, the thing with T.I., there's not really nothing that's standing out that I'm like, oh, shit, I gotta go back to the song.
Track 1,
Fucking
Under the Sun, fire. I like the sample, the way it flipped and you know, Cole's verse when he comes in. I forgot who had the second verse. Was it Saba? Cole did the first verse. I think Saba was in the second verse. The baby on the third verse. All of them did their thing. I think the second joint was Down Bad, which came out a while ago. Love that song. You know, Middle Child, we heard already for months. They dropped the joint. I like the joint with even Reason, the song Reason and Boz. That's a dope song, but I think Reason stole the show again. I think Reason outshined him. He represented for TDE.
Yeah, definitely.
They got outshined by other artists. Dreamville didn't, because I was telling Pete the same thing, you know, because he told me about Earth Gang and all them dudes, and I'm like, all right, hopefully this album will make me ask, okay, which one is that? Who that? Let me go listen to his catalog. None of them stood out, and I really don't want to go back to none of the other work. You know what I mean? Nothing really stood out to me from the people that I kind of didn't know already, that, you know what I'm saying? So,
yeah.
Came and went. Khaled's album came and went. I didn't listen to Tyler the Creator's album.
No. Me neither. I heard like one song wasn't bad. But that's really all I heard. Fucking what do you call it? Logic album. Like,
came and went.
There's literally nothing on it that I have to go back to. It wasn't a bad album, but it was nothing that I was like, oh, I need to go back to this. Yeah. Schoolboy Q album, I was very disappointed in. Schoolboy Q album. I did enjoy Jim Jones' album.
Yes.
El Chapo was good. Mm-hmm. I like Benny the Butcher's album. He was spitting. Like, that's what he does, though. So I enjoyed that. The song was pushed, though.
Mm-hmm. 18 Wheeler.
I fucked with that. I actually like Denzel Curry's album, but again, it's nothing I'm gonna really, really go back to. Mm-hmm. So there's that. Then, you know, I told you about the Beast Coast album. That album was pretty good, but it was just like rappity rap album. Nothing to go back to love.
I couldn't get into
Chris Brown's album. Disappointed me. Like,
you know what? It's a lot of songs. I could probably find 10 or 12 to make one good album.
Not the fact that not only is it too many songs, but on top of being too many songs, some of the songs are repeated from the last album. Like, Undecided was on there again, which I don't get.
Was it? Like, it was on both?
Yeah.
Oh, wow. I didn't know that was... I thought that was on this album only. I didn't know it was on the last one, too. I remember I heard it for a while, but I didn't know it was on the last album.
Because I'm not a huge Chris Brown person. Mm-hmm. So, like, I like Autumn Leaves Chris Brown. That's my Chris Brown. I don't mm-hmm. like all the other... Like, that's my Chris Brown. I love that kind of Chris Brown. So, I wanted to give a shit a chance, and I was like, all right, let me listen to it. And I could have swore when I downloaded his last album, it was the first time I ever heard Undecided. I could be wrong. Mm-hmm. I could have swore it was the first time I ever heard it.
It's been out for a while, so you might not be wrong. I'll look it up.
Benedict Butcher, what we got? Then Denzel Curry, Dreamville Logic. But I mean, so far, like Summer Walker's EP, I love. I'm a huge Summer Walker fan. Mm-hmm. I think Summer Walker is like, to me, she's like the fucking soul, fucking hood, fucking Adele. Like, she makes that great, like, I'm heartbroken, you're heartbroken, we're heartbroken songs. Like, I love Summer Walker. So her EP was good, but it's only fucking 10 minutes long. It's five mm-hmm. songs. One song is like 45 seconds.
Yeah, that's ridiculous. But then
she had that song Riot on there, which is amazing. Mm-hmm. Fucking Riot, well, that's my shit. Mm-hmm. But so far, album of the year for me is Boogie. Like, I love Boogie album from start to finish. Like, I have no skips on that album. I love the concept, the way he did it. Like, that shit was dope, and the way he spun into the whole album, mm-hmm. fucking dope. And then, in my opinion, I mean, which, depending on which Eminem you get, it's not always that hard, but for an artist I never heard before, to me, on that track, he outshined M 100%. Like, his bars and verses, like, yeah, like, on fucking, on that, I forgot the name of the fucking song, but, yeah, like, it was doing the, like having sex with a sheep, fuck what you heard. Like, he was doing, like, his stupid fucking little things.
Yeah.
And Boogie, a kid I never heard of, was fucking spitting. I was like, all right, that's dope.
Yeah, typical M. Typical Eminem stuff, like, you know.
Yeah, but see, when M does it on his own, I don't mind as much. When he does it on a feature, it's the worst, because now you're letting someone get the best of you, which old M used to not do. This new M does this shit. This relapse and past M does that shit. Because, not even that, because Forever M bodied the shit. I guess he does it when he wants to. Sometimes he's just lazy.
I think, I guess when he has something to prove.
Even the shit with Logic, it's not the best M verse. Like, he lyrically, he's going in, but he's still not saying much. It's not a kamikaze.
The best part of the song with Logic was when he flipped the comedian dude.
Yeah.
When he flipped his fake verse and actually put real words to it and made sense. That was like the best part of it, because I caught it the first time I listened to it. I was like, wait a minute, did he just say? The cabana, got the bandana and the cabana. I was like, wait, did he just? But then I listened to it again. I was like, oh, he didn't say what he said. He used his cadence, but put like, I was like, all right, that was dope. But that was like the best part of the song in general. That's just a little quick, you know, just whatever for music and movies. But you know, of course, we're gonna do the full recap of the year, the end of the year, the hands of time. But yeah, as far as music goes, not much really stands out.
I mean, last year was amazing, so it made it really hard. But
yeah, they got spoiled. Stood
out. Like I said, Schoolboy Q should have stood out. Jim Jones, I think, did his thing. Like, not it wasn't too crazy, but he should have stood out. Fucking, and that fucking Dreamville album should have stood out, and it didn't. So hopefully, Jordan Lucas comes through. Hopefully, the surprise album we don't know about comes through. I'm hopeful for the Nas album.
Where's
but
Kendrick?
I don't know, man.
Where's Kendrick?
Nah, Kendrick ain't dropping yet. Kendrick ain't dropping yet. Kendrick next year.
It's been 2 years.
I'm going with next year. March, April.
He's due, man. This is his cycle. He's
no, you know who's fucking due? Reason. Where's my Reason album? TDE. Well, get on that shit. Yeah. I need a new TDE. I need a new Reason. I need a fucking new SZA. That's what I need.
Well, didn't SZA say she was retiring or something?
She can't retire. She's too good.
Listen, man.
That album was fucking phenomenal, bro. I'm still bumming that album.
Oh, you know, I go back to it, too. I definitely go back to it, too.
Great, bro.
Yeah. All right, well, we got some more to talk about, so we'll get on that. But I'll holler at you for now.
All right, bro.
Later.